possession. Was it as simple as ISO, kind of going to get that shot off, or was there another thing you were looking for?
We just wanted to get the matchup we wanted. He wasn't in the game, so, you know, we just picked on someone and, you know, Spo really just drew up a play to get me the ball in the space, and, you know, whether it was my shot or creating, you know, attacking and creating for someone else, you know, I could have shot it or I could have went to the rim and dished it off to Bam or somebody on the weak side for a three, but, you know, lucky enough it went in.
I'm sure you're working on it to some degree, but how exactly do you work on a shot like that, fake up and to your right? And is it harder when you have to bring it over across your body?
Yeah, especially going left, you know, when you pump fake. But I shot the same shot actually like twice throughout the game where I pump fake, he flew by and I reloaded and, you know, I missed. But I can make that shot. I work on a lot of different shots, so I think I can make a lot of different shots.
Tyler, on the other side, they were saying that shot was a travel. Did you feel like you were able to keep your pivot foot? I know it was the pump fake and had to have some good footwork there, but did you feel like you were able to keep your pivot foot on that play?
I don't think it was a travel. But early in the game, they called a travel on me that I also didn't think was a travel. I think I hit a mid-range pull-up like right before, and they called a travel. So, I mean, just like last night with Jordan Poole, I mean, you could call a carry on every play. You can call it travel, I'm pretty sure, on almost every play. So, you got to take that one on the chin.
In your walk-off, I don't know if you mentioned this. I came in late. I apologize. Was it the intent from the get-go to pump fake and get him in the air? Or if you had the clean look right away, would you have gone for it? Or do you just expect that they were going to go for the pump fake, so you figured you can give yourself a little bit better space?
I mean, I was going to go to the rim, and then I seen once Gabe cut through, his guys started shaping up for help. And that when I seen that, that's when I stepped back. And I probably could have got this step back off, but with that space, I just wanted to test the fence and see if he would jump, which he did. And whether he jumped into me, I could have got the foul, or he jumped across. I reloaded and was able to knock it down.
Tyler, you always talk about the pick and roll connection with Bam, and in the fourth quarter, you kept getting to the mid-range pull-up, like you were saying, and that's kind of the pick and roll thing. And it was with a lot of spacing, different kind of lineups. Do you notice that evolving and kind of getting different looks at that point in the game with that combo?
Yeah. You know, we got a bunch of different lineups that we've thrown out there, but tonight we've seen, I think, me, Kyle, Duncan, Gabe, and Bam. So pretty much four guards, you know, surrounded by Bam. It's hard to help off our shooters, you know, whether it's me off the ball or on the ball with Duncan and Max or even Gabe and Kyle. It's tough to help with all that space. And then, you know, when Bam's attacking, it's the same thing. We got a bunch of shooters around him. It's tough to help. And then you got Duncan flying off, and he's creating triggers and stuff like that. So we're not easy to guard, and that's why when we move the ball, I think that's when we look our best.
We've seen you hit quite a few big shots since even your rookie year, but back then a lot of them would come off Jimmy's creation or in transition. Mm-hmm. What has your experience of the past 3 years kind of helped you with in terms of that situation to that tonight where it's ball in your hands, 12 seconds left, you got to create in the half court?
Yeah, it's different. You know, like you said, you know, Jimmy's usually the one creating at that end of – at the end of the game and collapsing the defense and making plays. Obviously those three, I mean, last 3 years I watch around the league. I watch Jimmy, how he closes games. I think I still took a bad shot like 3 minutes left in the fourth that really, you know, made me mad. So I think there's still learning curves. I think it's underrated. I think closing out games is a skill. You know, there's different things that go on towards the end of a game that you really got to make the right decision. So I still think I could have been better at the end, but the shot was cool, but I think I could still have been better.
All right, all the way from Greece, Christo Saltis, go ahead.
Yes. Been my guy. I haven't talked to you in a while, man. How you doing?
Tyler, how are you?
I'm good, man. How are you?
I'm fine. Great game, great shot, first of all. Speaking about your decision making, what is the biggest progress, the biggest development that you made, especially into this season?
Just being patient, you know, coming off screens, handoffs, just being patient, trying to make the right play. And obviously, when Bam's rolling, it's a big target to hit. And it makes it easy on me with a guy like that rolling to the basket. So, you know, just being patient and trying to read the defense.
Thank you very much. Keep up.
Thank you, my brother. Your name's not Christos.
I'll go to Greece and call you from there next time.
Appreciate you guys.